Hello, Eternal friends. Welcome back. We have our winner from the Eternal Tournament of Power, the tournament that we run where I take all of the subdecks that were submitted to me over the last month and fight them off against the ranked ladder until there's only one deck remaining. This month it happened to be Expedition, which I have not played a lot of, but this deck is really, really fun. I go over it in the deck tech. I'm not going to go into it too much now. Suffice to say, it's a mono fire dragons list. Trying to utilize especially things like Tota Pioneer and Tattoo Dragon, which is why I was really sad I couldn't get that last hand, because I actually think Tota Pioneer might be better than Tattoo Dragon in this list, which is saying a lot, but it's been really, really good. In any case, we're going to run it through some games here. I'm excited about this list for sure. It's been a lot of fun. I could lead with Teething Whelp. I think we do. Let them use some removal there if possible, and then we can play Covetous Stranger because it might actually be more important thanks to Tattoo Dragon. Yeah. And hopefully we draw another power card, which we do. Play both of these. Continue to try and keep up pressure, force them to have removal. And they obviously have something else. Ooh, they have Essence. Oh, wow. Gross. Yeah, that's a pretty big problem for us. We'll play the Tattoo Dragon. Hopefully they run out of removal eventually. That was really sick, though. Incredible start for our opponent. We'll see what happens.
An awesome
Sunset Priest. Sure. Oof, got another Tattoo Dragon and another Covetous Stranger. Sick. Oh, and they immediately hit... Wow, they also hit those, huh? Let's go ahead and play a Covetous Stranger. We'll attack. And I think I just want to leave up the Seer, because they might actually attack in, and we'll be able to use Seer to get the Covetous Stranger back in on the other side of this, which feels more important than anything else. Yeah, like now, we can do this, make it a little bit more likely for us to get the Stranger in. They have Backlash or something. Devour. Touch of Resilience. Okay. That's certainly interesting. I'm pretty okay with that. Ooh, Tota Pioneer. Well, well, well. Speaking of cards that we really wanted to see, it's unfortunate that we can't use the Tota Pioneer Overwhelm ability, like, right now, when we have four. But this is pretty good. Oh, wow, they didn't block anything. Alright, cool. I'm happy to draw more cards. I think I still play Burning Cordrake. We know that they have the Essence Feasts in their deck, but we're not anywhere near where they're going to be able to get the Lifesteal or Deadly on it. And, I mean, if they kill Burning Core and the Covetous Stranger, that's bad, but it's hardly the end of the game. Okay, another Touch of Resilience, sure. And an attack. They have to have some kind of mass removal then. Yeah, they did get another Essence Feast. Wow, two of them is pretty sick. Really, really sick. Super unfortunate for us, but we've still got some things to do here. Raise the nightmare. I mean, we're dealing a fair bit of damage. Got another spell on one. Still have that one on one. Hmm. So now we can pump Kozen, which is pretty sick. They're gonna Icy Gaze Kozen, sure. So that's what they had the whole time. But it does put them to one. We'll see how they manage to come out of this one. Yeah, I don't think they do. Nice. Whew! That got a little scary. They had a lot of removal against us. But thankfully, we were just able to keep the pressure up and end that game real quick like we meant to. Alright, we had a pretty good first game. This deck is living up to its name of Play Dragon Smash Face. Sorry, Play Dargons. Problem here is we don't have three for Kozen and Burning Core yet. We are on the draw. Maybe I'm okay with this. Maybe I'm okay with this. This one's close. If we don't draw the power card, then we're in trouble. But I like having Kozen Burning Core. Ticking Gremlin. Okay. Fair enough. aggro on aggro. See what happens. Yeah, we'll not block that. If anything, we'd rather trade attacking in. Oh, they're gonna just blaze the salvo in. Okay. I mean, fair enough. Just thinking about doing that with their own ticking grenadine. Kind of a mirror match, it looks like. I mean, obviously wildly different cards in some ways, but probably a similar strategy and just get down fast and beat face, which means they could be doing a bunch of different things. Wouldn't be surprised if they had something like Phoenix Stone or like Seer in the market. That's pretty common I've seen. Factory Quota might be in there, or like another trick like Rampage. So, I love Tota Pioneer, like I've said before, it's maybe one of the most important cards in the deck, if not just the most important. But, I'm positive they went and got removal of some kind, or they have it in their hand. I think I still play it. It'll mean that Kozen or Burning Cordrake can dodge things instead, which is still pretty good for us. Also, people have just criminally underrated Tota Pioneer and what a threat it is, so I think that we'll do that. Hope that, oh, they went for Plunder. Okay. That's interesting. I don't think that's bad. I just wasn't expecting it. Huh. Cool. Alright, so now we've got Kozen. We can slam Burning Cordrake and draw an extra card, get extra value off of that. We can then use Blazing Salvo. They have their own. Perfect. That makes perfect sense. We can actually instead, we can Edict of Shavka that. Kinda like it. It's a bit unfortunate that we don't get enough power to play a Burning Core or something afterwards, but I am not letting that thing live. Opponent angry that we had a burn spell. Which, okay. I mean, I even had to use two. That wasn't even great for us, really. Ooh, touch of force, huh? And Fireman Cub? Huh. Wow, that actually kind of gets us. Well, I'll play Burning Core, and then I think that we just hold back. We're in pretty good shape here. Two of the cards in their hand are Treasure Troves, so they're not going to do too much there. And we get good blocks out of our Kozen, that's for sure. Burning Core can just kind of threaten them in the air. Alright. So I like Emblem. I don't think we decimate here, actually. Embrace the nightmare. And yeah, I'm willing to attack with this Kozen since we have a Blazing Salvo up and waiting for any of their attacks. I think that that's okay. Double damage on this Ticking Grenadine certainly is something. Oh wow, they've got another Touch of Force. Really into that one, huh? Is there anything that I want to do here? I can go for a Rampage, which is kind of neat. I think that trading for a Treasure Trove is not bad. And the big question is, what do I kill? I think that I just kill Fire Main Cub. Grab the Rampage. And then we've still got some pretty good attacks here. They can double block. Nope. Oh, what am I... That's not enough. What am I thinking? Oops. Well, that's me just making a very dumb mistake. I don't know why I thought that was plus four for a second. Instead of plus three. It's okay. We're still getting a ton of value out of this. I don't think we're gonna lose this game. But that was a huge mistake. My brain just said that I'd be able to kill it that way for some reason. Another Fire Main Cub. Not killing the flyer. I will double block this, sure. It doesn't actually kill anything. Huh. Well, one good mistake deserves another. Because, boy, I made a real bad one, and then I think they made a worse one. Whoops. To be fair, we were definitely winning at that point with all the treasure troves. They're probably just kind of throwing in the towel there in an abstract way. That was a bad move by me. I don't know why my brain said, oh, well, when they block, of course I'm going to use this. I think it might have just been that all of them, like, the Kozen on their side had double damage, and my brain just said that all Kozens have double damage or something. I don't know why my brain shortcutted that, but hey, sometimes you make mistakes, and I just get to show you all of mine. So hopefully you enjoyed watching me punt that away a little bit. So as we've won every game, we obviously have made no mistakes. Our results show that. Results-oriented thinking. Always works. It gets results. Do we mulligan this or not? We've got a lot of good two drops. Double emblem is a little worrying. But I do like double teething well. This one's close. I think I'm going to keep it. We are an aggressive deck. We want to have a hand that doesn't have a ton of power. Like, it's probably worse for us most of the time to draw just, like, five power cards rather than just be stuck on two, because there's a lot of things that we can do on two power. But I don't know. It's close. It's definitely close to being something that I'd throw back. Like, we draw Catu Dragon, I'm going to feel pretty bad. But at the same time, yeah, or Eclipse Dragon. At the same time, we can just take over a game by playing some of these Teething Whelps, right? They might not actually have a quick answer to all of them. And if we're able to get that pressure down fast and early, we can just close out a game before it even matters that we can't play a Teething... we can't play a Tattoo Dragon kind of card or an Eclipse Dragon. What do they have? Transpose. Next. Really wish we'd drawn a power card here so I could play Kozen before the next Teething Whelp, but I think I still just get another Whelp down. It's just more pressure than Covetous Stranger is, and it's going to be hard for us to utilize those treasure troves while we're stuck on power like this. It's both good and bad to have the treasure troves in this kind of a situation, in that, like, oh, wow, boy. yeah, that's a lot of Eclipse Dragons, but they can dig us down to more power cards. The problem is that playing them in the first place means we're taking an entire turn off, right? Which is kind of problematic. Alright, well, I think that we're priced into just slamming things onto the board. Like, we can't hold back for them possibly having removal because we don't have anything else to do. We can't hold up a Blazing Salvo or Sears or anything like that, because we just don't have any cards. Yikes. Alright, well, I didn't expect to go five cards in and not see a power. I kept it, but I also didn't quite expect this. We do still have Blazing Salvos. Like, we've still got some things to get out here. I think that Blazing Salvo for Factory Quota could be a big deal. In fact. Like, it definitely makes sense to just do that right now. Like, go for the Draconic Ire, I guess. We could play Kozen Darkheart. I mean, there's a bunch of options here for sure. Like, I'm not terribly scared of, like, Blazing Salvoing our own unit to try and grab that factory quota. I kind of like it. I think that might be the best thing for us to do. We do not need this many Eclipse Dragons. Factory Quota being really cool in that it ignores their face Aegis, essentially. Like, they'll be able to stop damage for it at first, but it's not like the relic gets stopped, right? So, like, this first thing of damage is going to be stopped.
But then after that, now they have to deal with it.
Embrace the nightmare.
Alright, sounds good. Pass turn. We can go ahead and grab Rampage out of the market. Try and get our Cozen Darkheart to go off right away. They're gonna decimate, sure. This is an interesting control deck. I like it. They have a lot of power. It's actually good. Not being able to ambush that is kind of sweet for us. I'm gonna get rid of the treasure trove. I'm not 100% certain that's right. Tough. Okay, I'm gonna attack. I think we go for the Rampage. I'm definitely a little worried if they have something. Okay, they don't. That's good.
Souls fire.
I don't want to use the Seer yet, because I'd really like to use Touch of Force. In the meantime, let's just draw another card. Sweet. Now we're in incredible shape. Even if they just keep wiping the board, Eclipse Dragon into Eclipse Dragon. They can't wipe out Eclipse Dragon with Shenron Speaks, not before it deals the damage. And they're taking damage from our relic this whole time, too. That factory quota is just kind of getting them. They might not even have a unit to play next turn. And I mean, oh, right, yeah. Also, Eclipse Dragon has more text on that. So the minute they give us an option to actually play something, we're just gonna sear them. Like that. Oh, okay. Well, they're scooping anyways, fair enough. I guess they didn't have a way to deal with the Eclipse Dragon and the factory quota is my guess. It'd make sense. We're doing good. We're doing real good. 3-0. We haven't even managed to get the really insane Tota Pioneer turns yet. But it's been awesome so far. 3-0, 3-0. Doing great. This deck's been just performing perfectly. I think I like this hand. I mean, it's sad that we have to pledge away a Tattoo Dragon, but then we get to go Stranger into Teething Whelp or Pioneer into Burning Core, maybe. And that seems good enough for me. I wish that we were on the play, because obviously being an aggressive deck, we kind of always want to be smashing face. That's the name of the game. Play Dargons, smash the face. So, Dragonsmith is scary enough that I kind of just want to kill it right away. If they have a Teething Whelp, it's such bad news for us. I hate it. I'm not sure that I should play it or not. Because, I mean, next turn, we can Tota. On turn 3, we can Salvo and get mana for it because of Tota Pioneer. But, man, that's a long time to wait. I think I just kill it. It's going to be such a key card to their deck. I can get rid of one of these Ruthless Strangers. Probably go for an Edict of Shavka. We'll see what happens. Yup, good call. That was a good call then. Playing our own Teething Whelp. I guess we're going to have to be playing a little defensively here. I said this is the difference between being on the play and being on the draw for sure. Aggro mirror kind of thing like this. Pretty big disadvantage. But Tota Pioneer can play the long game well. We just need to draw the right power for it. Yeah. Ouch. Come on, power card. Let us get Burning Core. I hope. Covetous. Alright. I mean, we can play that, Tota Pioneer then becomes free next turn. If we draw another power card, we can do stuff. Wow, that actually, funny enough, that hoses the Tota Pioneer play here. We don't get to play both this turn. Because now our second card has already been drawn, so it's not going to matter. I don't get to play Edict and Tota. They couldn't have known. I very highly doubt they knew that. But boy, it sucks. Alright, kill that. Gonna have a lot of trouble dealing with this Teething Welt now, though. A little bit stuck on power. We've done really well so far. You know, one of these games, we're gonna get stuck and be on the draw. It's a thing that happens. Oof. Oh, it's so close to being with enough time. Alright, let's play the Tota. You get an attack, then it's free. Could just play Burning Core. I think I like Kozen.
Embrace the nightmare.
Because Kozen is another way for us to draw a second power card in a turn. Someone that knows that Tota Pioneer is the problem. Uh-oh. That's an issue. Like I said, most people haven't realized that that's the card they need to kill, surprisingly enough.
Our memories give us strength.
We'll see what we can do. We can block for a turn to save ourselves some damage. We can try and race, which is, ooh boy, a little dicey. I'm thinking that we might take this. God, I mean, it sucks. It sucks a lot. But I might have to take this because I feel like maybe our only out is to draw Seer. God, but even then we can't still block because this is reckless. Oh, this is a tough one. I guess that we're just stuck blocking. I don't think I can realistically kick it. They did pause too, so probably a good block. Man, I want Eclipse Dragon to matter here. I wish I could attack that. If we attack with everything, we're attacking for 10. And put it so that they're dead next turn. But they've got 6 cards in hand. They paused. I don't think I can realistically do it. Think that I attack like this, see what they do first. Post-combat Eclipse Dragon feels real stupid. I'm not happy about that, but again. Dragon Forge, okay. That might have been the only fast spell, but I don't think I can take that risk with them having this many cards in hand. And obviously having things like Provoke the Dragons. And I can't imagine they don't have Seer or Char or something in there like that. Like, they're gonna have... Yeah, especially with, like, Aesthonis. Now I take it. Because I think that our best chance is to just get in here. Go for the Rampage? Is there a way for us to kill them that way? We kill this. They block here. It's not enough, right? No. It's close, though. And it does mean that we can get a blocker. Okay, I like this. Seems like our best option is to do this. They have to block something or they die. In which case we get to kill Aesthonis. We also get a blocker out of this. So that's a thing. So that's already dying. And give it 3, which doesn't really do anything. Do we even play that? We got 3. God, it's we can put them to 9. I mean, we can deal 9 at to them. So close. I kind of feel like we wait.
Soul's fire, aid me.
And now I can draw some cards. See if we get anything. Guess if I'd done that before, we might have had something. The BM good game before the game's over always sucks. If I'd drawn first, we would have had Ruthless, when we might have been able to do something. Yeah. That GG really sucks. Oh well. Yeah, I should have done something a little bit different and just gone for the stranger right away. Drawn first. Definitely a little bit of a mistake there because we would have put them in a position where they'd have to lose. So I definitely misplayed. Could have played this, I could have gone for the Ruthless Stranger. I wasn't thinking about that. I didn't think of Ruthless Stranger really being an out there. And I thought I could just sear afterwards. That was the card that I was really concentrating on. I forgot that Ruthless Stranger would actually pump up two units beforehand. And then it just happened that that was the one card that we had. We'd already played two as well, so it wasn't like a huge thought in my mind. It was a low chance of us actually hitting it. Getting a little bit of PM there at the end for some reason from our opponent. I don't know why. But, yeah, I mean, close game. Really, really close. Definitely came down to a couple of little mistakes on our end, I think. So, good things to know for next time. It's part of, like, learning a new deck is just figuring out all of the different lines of play that you have and realizing some of those things that you might not have thought of right off the top of your head in those moments. You only have a certain amount of time to get through a game, and thinking about what your outs can be is one of those things that you've just got to play the deck a fair bit to kind of get used to it, or have like a deck list up on the side is always a good idea. I don't have it right now, which I probably should, because if I had, I might have thought of the Ruthless Stranger. But I was really like, we have Caleb's Favor, we've got Seer. I was kind of thinking of those types of things and wasn't actually thinking, oh hey, if we just top deck Ruthless Stranger, that's also the game. So, you know, unfortunate that it was the thing that we did draw. We could have actually won the game, but it's nice to know that there was a thing we could do that would have actually saved us from dying there. So that's always a nice... It's always kind of... I actually like those moments. I'd rather have a game where I can see a line where I made a mistake or I could maybe have tried something different that could work out and it's a learning experience to bring into the future, rather than a game where I'm just like stuck on power and there's nearly nothing that I could have done about it. I don't like that style of game because the only thing I can learn from that is don't draw so much power, idiot. Like, there's get luckier. I don't like that kind of a thing. But this one, like, we can actually learn from that. We now know a little bit more about our deck. We've thought of another line of an out, and it's something that we can take into the future and realize, oh, okay, yeah, I probably should have thought that Ruthless Stranger can actually pump pre-combat and has to pump pre-combat, rather than just relying entirely on the actual burn spells that we have. So it's a nice little thing to note and to learn about our deck. 3-0. We are kicking some ass. Oh, wow, this hand looks great. I'm definitely keeping this. Code of Pioneer, Caleb's Favor to make it cheap. On the play, everything's fantastic here. We probably want to lead with Covetous Stranger, because again, like, if we can draw a card in the same turn as Code of Pioneer, it's free. So we just go ahead and Covetous. If we can attack with it, then we get to Code of Pioneer and have it, like I said, be entirely free. No, I needed you to live. That's okay. I mean, it means that Tota Pioneer gets to live here too, which is actually okay. We can still go ahead and, like, Emblem of Shavka. And actually, that means we get to play another Tota Pioneer for free. Cool. Or we can play the Ash Elemental, but I think I'd rather just play another Tota. Because now, like, Caleb's Favor is just going to be making us power. They paused there. Did they have another Blazing Salvo? Certainly possible. Yep. Wow. Gross. Alright, well, a lot of removal in a row here is a problem. See how much they have. I mean, going to the market twice is scary, scary. Yeah, just all removal. Oof. Rough. It looked really good for us, but that was some insane turn from our opponent. Start with the Ash Elemental. Hopefully we can get some Caleb's Favors off. That was really, really, really good. Mm-hmm. At least there is some good news here. We can use Seer to just kill that. They won't block, but I definitely offer the block here first. Seems like they're on a pretty similar plan to what we're doing. Edicumland Ryan, nice. Really, really good market. I mean, this is the problem, right? We knew that they were just going to have non-stop incredible turns because of that Bladewing Salvo early plays. We're still actually in decent shape, though, because Eclipse Dragon here, if they don't just kill Kozen, does give us a lot of value. And we get to follow it up with our own Eclipse Dragon. Obviously, the treasure trove is nice. And we can just slam in here. We're a long ways ahead on the actual damage, so if they don't have something crazy to follow it up with, we should be okay. I honestly think they might have just been wanting to attack with these and not care about our Kozen, but I'm happy that they're doing it this way. So, Tota Pioneer is free again. Drawing the third one was really good. Just keep slamming in for value. Another Eclipse Dragon. Nice. Yeah, we've got a lot of damage coming down on them. I don't think they can keep attacking to the Eclipse Dragon. That Draconis is incredible, though. That's a really, really, really good top deck. Oh, wow. And I mean, making it cheaper from the Spellbound, that might be the best draw they could have had in their deck. It's gotta be close. Yikes. Let's go for it. Put them to 5. We can use this to deal some extra damage next turn, maybe.
Embrace the nightmare.
Okay. Unfortunately, I don't think we have a way out of this. And now they just trade. Put them to 2. We can draw the extra card, but we've already gotten the power off of that. Oh, no, we haven't, sorry. I mean, Draconic Ire can kill something, just the Spellbound Vestige, but that doesn't matter. The Spellbound Vestige, there's really nothing we can do. We needed to draw, Caleb's or a Seer, something like that. Close! Close game, though. Really close. Alright. That was a fun one. That was a sick top deck. Oh, wait! No! Draconic Ire deals 2 damage! Right! Ryder deals damage equal to the... Oh my goodness, I totally forgot for a second. And then I was like, well, I might as well do that. Oh, I didn't mean to slow roll them. Oh, I didn't mean to be mean like that. I never played Draconic Ire. It's not a card that I play often. That's amazing. Wow. Wow. Oh, wow. The best part is that the last game that we played, the game 4, was an accident. I accidentally played it in Throne, and it was the only one that we lost so far. I'm gonna play another one because I actually want to get 5 games in Expedition. We made a mistake in that last one, too. Like I said, just learning about our deck, right? It's funny, I like those kinds of games where we can just learn a little bit about the cards that we're playing. You've got to play with a lot of cards, and you got to get a lot of experience with them. I mean, I've put in 6,000 hours around, literally, into Eternal, and it's still so easy to forget what some cards do if you're not playing with them all the time. And I totally forgot that Draconic Ire also deals damage. I did not think about it in the slightest. That was really, really silly of me, and I'm glad that we did it, because we got there. Let's get in final game, and let's take it home. Yeah, I feel like that last game really shows and exemplifies that, like, adage of practice, practice, practice. You've got to really learn your decks. You can play a lot of Eternal, but if you're not playing the right cards all the time, like, learning a deck still requires some time, even if you know the cards. Just thinking of the lines and how they interact and how they play against other decks will take you some time, and thinking of all of those things while also remembering what all of your cards do if you haven't always played with them can definitely mess you up a bit, and it definitely did for me there, because I can't believe I almost didn't kill my opponent with Draconic Ire. But hey, we did it! We are 4-0 in Expedition. Let's go. Whew. This deck's been doing really, really well today, and I'm very happy for it.
We are.
Again, we're going to lead with Covetous Stranger so that Tota Pioneer can just be cheap next turn. And then also to maybe just draw, not draw, dodge some removal, I imagine. Oh, crack here. Okay. Just thinking it might have been... Oh, no, that's not a fast spell. The Vara's Intervention that a lot of people are running to minus two. But that's not actually fast. They wouldn't have been able to do it at this speed. Crack the Earth is obnoxious right now, for sure. Still have some things we can do. I mean, I could just Kozen next turn, too. Instead of worrying about drawing the extra power card. I guess I can do both, though. Hello? Think... I mean, I hate... Oh, God. And we even give them ramp, too. It might just be better to wait and play Kozen. Boy, I hate that. I don't like that. But I think that that's actually the thing to do. I don't really want to throw this and let them have a bunch of power trading off our stranger just for that. It's just so little. Hopefully we draw a power card. Like, that's the scary thing about this line is that we need to draw power so we can, like, Tattoo Dragon or Tota Pioneer and Whelp. And then also use the Treasure Trove because we'll get the Tota for free. Don't... yep. Yeah. Rough. Wow, and that's a cultist too. Sick. Ooh, this is gonna be a tough game. They've got an insane hand here. I definitely need to kill that first, though. We can wait. Get the extra power. Stop them from having three extra. We do not need them at seven. And yeah, I mean, I like this a lot more than them being on seven, that's for sure. That amount of ramp was unconscionable. What an incredible start. Cool deck. Yikes. They can play what they got out of their market. They've got the five. I really need our power. That's the big thing. Travers Farm. Okay. And if we draw a power card, we can actually just use the Tota Pioneer to kill that.
Our magic
or not.
Is on.
Or could we? So Caleb's is free and gets us the power. Which means that I can overwhelm. I can force them to lose the farm. Or the stranger, which I like. I think I'm pretty happy with either outcome there. And I don't love letting them have this magnificent stranger, but it could definitely be worse.
Listen,
Rectifier to silence that.
Reborn.
Ah, they knew! Yeah, I mean, probably because of the fact they kind of read this one for a little while, so I wasn't sure if they were actually going to silence it. Much prefer if they'd silence this, obviously. Because this just gives us so much extra value off of free cards, but... Ooh, hello. That's cool. Yeah, I'm pretty willing to let this happen. Get ourselves a free 2-2. They'll block, because then they're able to use the silence on the dragon.
And be reborn.
But that's not going to totally stop us either. We still got a 2-2 out of it. And it's still a 4-3 to stop their magnificent stranger. That's the scary
thing. Struggle and grow.
That's the one that we really didn't want to see.
Listen and be reborn.
Oh. They're going to play another Sanctifier, Rectifier rather than just sacrificing that one. Huh. Okay. I mean, we've got double blocks for the Grodovs. I could just use Eclipse Dragon. Could also just play this Tattoo Dragon again. Try and make more value that way. I think I like that for now. It uses the most power this turn as well. So I think that's the best thing to do. And hopefully they don't have any more really, really big windmill slams like this Grodov's. Oh, wow, their hand is really, 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 really good. Yikes. Double Grodov's is scary. I mean, we've had double Tattoo Dragon, like, don't get me wrong, our hand hasn't been bad, but... Whoa. Their start was crazy, too. It's gonna be a close game. It might now just be a blowout, honestly. Yeah, smart of them to shuffle in our deck as well. And they have the removal. Yeah. That was one of the two cards they drew, too. Ouch. Didn't have it a second ago. That seems like it's enough to kill this game for sure. There are a billion cards up on us now. Yeah. Yeah, just a little bit. It might be slightly favored. I need to hit a power card. I feel like our only real option here is to try and race them.
We earn our
key. Really, at least we get to do this. We can start using these Eclipse Dragons and trying to get in that way. Next turn we do get to slam down both, and that's 8 in the air. Like, I think we just have to race in the air and hope that they don't have enough ways to stop us. They're gonna draw a billion cards, though. That's the issue. Grodov. Okay.
Grodov, grant me strength.
Yeah, this is some incredible value. I'm gonna take it. I feel like one of our only outs is to maybe have some removal.
Is unbroken.
Yeah, another stranger, and they're just gonna be able to chain it just like we did. But probably a lot better, even. Yep. Okay.
Who says you can't play with fire?
We're definitely in chump block territory now. I wanted to take it there because I thought that maybe one of our only outs would be to actually have a removal spell for one of these and kind of turn it back around on them. But now, I mean, we're close! We're really close! If they don't have enough ways to deal with the flyers, it's still possible. It's gonna be really, 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 really ridiculously hard, but yeah.
We hunt and thrive.
And they can't attack with that. They can steal cards from us. Wow.
We struggle and grow.
At a certain point... Ah, there we go. Okay. Close, though. Like, it was actually surprisingly close. They had an incredible hand. Like, just buck wild. Getting 7 power by turn 3 or 4 was, pretty unbelievable. And we still got close. Like, despite that, despite having an absolutely buck wild, crazy hand to start, and just following it up over and over and over with Windmill Slam, incredibly powerful cards, Grodov's, 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 just again and again. We almost won. Like, we put them down to, they had to kill us that turn, or they were dead on the backswing. Granted, they overkilled us at that point. You know, not bad. Certainly did pretty well considering. And I was really happy with this deck. This deck is just very sweet. It does a lot of cool things. I'm very excited to play more of it. If you want to play a nice, fast, aggressive deck, that's not really expensive. Like, I mean, it's got some rares and things, but there's not a ton of legends. I mean, you're like basically looking at Kozen, the Soulfire Drake, and honestly, I haven't used them that much, so you could maybe budget those in a little bit, like I said. Maybe put in some more Dragon Forges to make sure that you're hitting Eclipse and Tattoo, because those have felt more important to me, honestly. And this is, those are the only legends, right? I mean, Phoenix Stone, I guess, in the market. There's not a lot of legends you have to worry about, and a lot of the cards are just kind of commons, uncommons. So, you know, you're not looking at a super expensive list here, at least, as far as what you can get into. Like, our opponent's deck in that last round was all legends. Like, that was just a ton of them. All the Makars and all of the all of the Grodov Strangers and the Horse Traverse Farms and, like, that, just tons and tons and tons of things. This one's pretty cheap in comparison to that, and it just does a lot of work. It's been winning a lot of games. I've been having a ton of fun with it. And congratulations again to Ganbatari for winning. So thank you for all the support, all of the subs and patrons who join up to these tournaments to make them possible. And it's a lot of fun for me to run through all of the weird decks that people give. We've had some very interesting ones. We had a Knucklebones deck that made it to like the top four. We've had a lot of really, really weird, cool ideas. I mean, last month we got like the ideas around doing more of a Relic Sacrifice kind of a deck because of all the submissions. They give me a lot of cool ideas, and there's a lot of really creative people in the community here, and I just think that it's a blast to do. So thank you for making it possible for me. And like I said in the deck tech video on this, if you want to be a part of that, you're not a sub or patron, you can't submit a deck, but we are going to be running some tournaments again soon. We run them every once in a while. You may have seen that we had one a little while ago that was a hero tournament. I'm going to be running something similar to that again, either a hero tournament or a peasant tournament where anybody can enter. They just have to do it through our Discord so we can kind of arrange everything, and we'll do some scheduling up of some matches and see who's got the the goods as far as either a peasant format or a hero format. You can make your own decks, and I'll do some commentary on that on stream, and it'll be a lot of fun. So we'll try and arrange some other things like that for the community, and I will see you soon with some more decks.